that awareness message to the villages, to the malls, to the schools in our district, Clarence.
So I'm here at a conference for World Heart Day. That's me right there.
We have a drug dream because her husband died in Hong Kong in our dream in Rafi, and I passed surgery somewhere in the hospital a few weeks ago, and she's daily to 100% mortality. Should we stop traveling by here?
Also, some family director, that is serious.
So today is 10th October and it is 3 o'clock in the afternoon. We just finished the conference and now I'm on my way back. I think I might go for a bit of grocery shopping with my mother. So I'm at the grocery store and I was looking for my favorite biscuits, but I can't find them. I'm looking for peanut pick cookies. Khasti, my wake up call. Khasti, these are so cute. I got Khasti with my favorite book the other day and I love it.
Hello guys, today is 10th October and it is almost 5 o'clock in the evening. I had a World Heart Day symposium today, as you already saw, and after the symposium I went grocery shopping with my mother and now I'm going back home. So I'm almost finishing Wives and Daughters. I have only 100 more pages to go, and once I'm done then I'm going to pick up The Way We Live Now, because I have not read from that book for a couple of days. I wanted to finish Wives and Daughters because it has been a while since I've been reading that book, and now since the story is so interesting I want to just finish it today. So that is all the update for Wicktober. I also managed to get myself Milo. I've been looking for this for ages. I love having a cup of Milo when I'm reading, so I've got this now. So guys, it's the same day. No wait, it's 12:30, so it's the next day. And I finished Wives and Daughters and I loved it. It was such a sweet book. I rushed through the last 300 pages and I enjoyed it a lot. I already knew the story. I wish I had not seen the BBC miniseries because it would have made the book so much better. I'm still on a Wives and Daughters high. I give it 5 stars on Goodreads. I could not even believe that North and South and Wives and Daughters are written by the same person, because they are so different. Not just the stories, but the way the story is told. Wives and Daughters is so subtle and soft, and it's such a slow-paced book, but even though it is so slow-paced, you don't get bored. I just loved every character in the book with all their flaws, and I just thought it was such a sweet book. Now that I have finished Wives and Daughters, I can pick up The Way We Live Now by Anthony Trollope and continue reading this. I have read 140 pages. I don't think I can read any other book tonight. I just want to savor Wives and Daughters. And I think I might pick up The Picture of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde as well, because I want to pick a shorter book. I don't want to pick Dracula yet because I know it's also not a very short book. And I was reading two long books consecutively and I think it just makes it a bit harder for me. So I want to pick a shorter book now to accompany this chunker, which is The Way We Live Now. I'm just going to have some chocolate milk in my Dobby mug and I'm going to continue thinking about Wives and Daughters. I think I want to watch the BBC miniseries again. It's been a year since I last saw it. So that is all the update for now.
I wish it would rain already, because it is so dusty in Peshawar these days. And I think one good shower is going to settle all the dust. It is
bit cloudy, but it doesn't seem like it's going to rain. Check this out. This is wheat which has recently been washed, and we're going to dry it and then crush it, and then we are going to use it to make some bread. Hi guys, it's 12th October and it's 5 o'clock in the evening. I just finished filming 10 of the longest books on my TBR. I'm going to edit it tonight and then post it tomorrow. I'm not sure when I'm going to upload this vlog, so maybe before or after that video. So I picked up The Way We Live Now by Anthony Trollope. I've read this much. I've also decided to pick up The Picture of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde. So this edition has a long introduction. I'm going to skip that because I'm pretty sure it contains spoilers. I read the preface yesterday and I already have highlights. Check this out.
Diversity of opinion about a work of art shows that the work is new, complex, and vital. How cool is that?
I also wanted to show you the two books I got in mail the other day. I ordered these two books from libertybooks.com and they have the best packaging. Check this out.
It says books are uniquely portable magic. How much sooner one tires of anything than of a book?
So the first book which I got was David Copperfield by Charles Dickens. I recently read Little Dorrit by Charles Dickens and I loved it. And I've heard that David Copperfield is one of his best works. So I got the Vintage Classics Red Spine Edition. It is such a long book. It is almost 880 pages long. And the second book which I got was the Penguin English Library Edition of The Portrait of a Lady by Henry James. And I think it is such a cute edition. It has these beautiful purses on it. And I have read one book by Henry James, which was The Europeans, and I really enjoyed it. This is also a very long book. It is almost 700 pages long. So this story is about a beautiful American who comes to Europe to get married, of course, but she decides to enjoy her freedom instead. And I think it sounds interesting. This is the aftermath of filming a BookTube video. I need to put all these books back and also this stack right here. So let's start. All the Penguin English Library editions need to go together. I'm reading this one, so I'm gonna keep this one here. And then also The Picture of Dorian Gray. These two are the Red Spines. Looking good, I think. And then I also have this Red Spine, which is Wife and Daughters, but I don't have space here, so this is going to go right here at the top. I'm still waiting for my friend to pick up her copy of Crime and Punishment. From this stack, I'm going to take the Colin Classics. So I'm going to put Shirley here, and then The Woman in White. And this one is going to go here. Why? Don't ask. It's just going to go here. Yep, better. And then I can put my Kindle on top. So this shelf is done. Vanity Fair will go on this stack. Huh. All my Penguin popular classics are stacked here. Bleak House will go right here. Yay! And this will go on top. So now this shelf is done. Then I have these two Oxford World's Classics edition. One can go here. This shelf is all tidy. And then this one. This one is going to go here. And then only one book is missing. And that is The Brothers Karamazov. So now all my bookshelves are in order and they are all looking great, if I say so myself. So I think I'm going to end my vlog here. I hope you all enjoy it. I will see you all in my next video. Bye.